First, a big win for National over the weekend, handed to them on a plate by the Greens. James Shaw has announced he's giving the opposition his party's allocated questions in Parliament so the government can be better held to account. With us now is National leader Simon Bridges. Tēnā koe, good morning.
Kia ora, good to be on your show.
How did this come about?
Yeah, look, I learned about it late last week, and I suppose ultimately, you know, if you think about it from our perspective, there's no strings attached. It's a great thing, and we welcome it, and we thank James Shaw and the Green Party because it enables us to hold the government better to account with more questions each day.
Has this been in the works for a while?
Not that I know of. That said, I mean, I think, you know, we can take what they say at face value, which is a principled stance from them. This is something they've talked about for a long time. They clearly don't like the patsies. I think they're a bit of a waste of time, particularly for, I suppose, a junior party in a government. And so from our side, we've got no qualms about that. And what I intend to do is make sure we take this with the spirit, I think, of the offer, which is to make sure we've got a seriousness of purpose about our questions and that we're asking them on things that matter, which include the economy, law and order, but also something of common interest to both of us, the Greens and National, and that's the environment.
For our viewers who don't religiously follow Question Time...
I'm sure they all do, Jack.
How many questions is this going to be?
Well, there's 12. And I suppose what's remarkable in a sense is my understanding is we have more questions than ever in history of Parliament as an opposition. So at the moment we either get 7 or 8, so it's pretty dominant already. This takes us to, depending, I suppose, 8, 9, 10 potentially on a given day, so most of the questions. And of course it's about getting answers out of ministers in their areas of responsibility.
You said we can take this at face value, and you know the Greens are doing this for broad principles of democracy. But yeah. Come on, there's a bit of politicking in this, isn't there?
I mean, I take James at his word. I think that's what he's saying.
He's trying to extend an olive branch.
Well, I think he's also said, though, you know, he is an independent party. You know, they're not quite as tied in to the Ardern Peters government, if you like. I mean, I think from our perspective, I don't read too much into it. What I would say, though, is I hope the Green Party does take notice of the fact that as a new leader, I've made clear I want to emphasise the environment more.
Yeah, just remind us where your climate change minister is on the list.
Yeah, absolutely.
What number?
Well, I think he's sort of 30-something.
But be clear about this.
I've been climate minister. I've been energy minister. I've thought a lot about these issues. I think, as I say, expect us to talk more about them.
You have at the very least talked about wanting to better foster the relationship between National and the Greens, and do you think that James Shaw is perhaps more open to that than he might have been 6 months ago?
I don't know, and I'm not looking, as I say, to read too much into this. I think it's a good deal, if you like, for us. Mm. Why wouldn't we take it? But I'm certainly open, the National Party's open, to working with them over this term on things we've got a common concern and interest about, and I think we'll find those issues.
There have been another spate of dairy robberies over the weekend. I know the last, when National was in government, you gave $1.8 million to help dairy owners better protect themselves. They say it's not enough and that not enough is being done. What can we do?
I think ultimately you've just got to keep the focus on this. And pretty simply, it's police resourcing, and I think it's also about good, strong law and order policy. And be very clear, this government has a policy of reducing prison populations by 30%. That's fine and dandy, but it's not if you don't also have good plans to reduce offending. I think ultimately if you don't have that, you're simply putting criminals out on the streets and you will see more burglaries and robberies and serious violence.
So you think if we had stricter penalties for the people who are committing these robberies, that'd be enough to reduce them?
Well, at the moment, you know, you've got a situation where we tightened up the bail, the sentencing, the parole laws. I know this government's actively looking at reducing them. Now, call me old-fashioned, but I think that's soft on crime. That makes the problem worse. I come back to my point. You've got to focus on this. You've got to have the resourcing and policing, but you also can't go soft on the policies.
So did the National government not do enough?
Look, this will always be an issue. I mean, I think as long as, you know, there are people. But actually, you saw crime reduce under us. This stuff's troubling. I think wherever it happens, it has very serious consequences for those involved. Keep the focus on.
Is it silly just to say, you know what, you got to choose one thing, either your safety or cigarettes? And the moment you stop selling cigarettes, given how expensive they are, especially you know, for people in low-income families and things, then that's probably the thing that's going to keep you the safest.
I suppose, though, whilst I understand what you're saying, the point is this. These dairy owners, supermarket owners and so on should have the ability to do that without expecting a thug coming in with a baseball bat and taking to them. Mm. And we should expect safety. I personally, as I say, a bit old-fashioned on these things, I think it is about deterrence, having good policies so that if they're caught, they do the time.
Very quickly, some criticism from people who were signed up to a national mailing list without realising they'd done so and getting the old emails in their inbox. What happened?
Well, I think as Rob Muldoon says, if you're going to choose between cock-up and conspiracy, choose cock-up every time. This is plain and simple cock-up. It's a situation where I think they're signing up to petitions, in this case around the airport down there in Kapiti Coast and wanting to continue to see flights in from Air New Zealand, and somehow they got signed up into more general National Party things. Shouldn't have happened, and we'll make sure we fix it.
OK, thanks for your time this morning. Really appreciate it. That is National Leader Simon Bridges.